Welcome everybody to a new Legacy video, finally with the new ban list active. So Deathrite-Shaman and Gitaxian Pro are effectively banned on Magic Online, and here we are recording with Goblins. Goblins is one of the decks that was the most stopped by the power of Deathrite-Shaman, not only because Deathrite-Shaman is a great card, but also because Goblin Lackey is a 1-1 and you really has to get through. What does this deck try to accomplish? We play 4 Goblin Lackey, which is almost like a show and tell for your goblins. Then play Mogwar Marshal. On the two drop slot, someone plays the Goblin Pile Driver, someone plays Warren Instigator, but I kinda like the Warren Marshal better. Steam Scourger, here to bounce Gormagangler, Emrakul, just you know, very versatile 2 mana goblins. Jump on Incinerator, kinda like removal draw card, very very strong 4-ofs. The Goblin Matron. It's like a recruiter of the guard for this deck, so again, very effective. Goblin Chieftain, Hasty Goblin, and Pump Your Team. Goblin War Chief, instead of reduced amount of cost, so in case you got like running Ringleaders, the War Chief is gonna help you a lot in smoothing your draws. Cranko Mob Boss, very strong with the War Chief or Chieftain, and finally Goblin Trashmaster, new card from M19. Not only does pump goblins, but it also destroys annoying artifacts such as Source of Warren, Fire Eyes, and etc. It can also just kill Engineered Explosives or Aether Vial, and the combo with Mogwar Marshal is real, since you have to sacrifice a goblin, and this indeed. And Goblins is famous for like their Goblins is not a deck that wins with like singular cards like Death and Taxes can do with like the Mother Runes into Thalia. Goblins just win with a critical mass of creatures, so like Ringleader, you want to hit multiple stuff, Siege Gang Commander, you want to just put a lot of power in the board, and then your opponent will be overwhelming card advantage. We play Fort or Fire. This is like the only interaction we have together with the Goblin Jump Up Incinerator. And many of those can say that Tar Fire is now no more needed because of Deathrite-Shaman. But the reality to me is that in a deck with 4 Goblin Ringleader, you just want to hit as much as possible. And if you just put like more creature instead of Tar Fire, like it could be more War Chief, more Chieftain, or Pile Driver, or like Kiki Jiki, or Goblin Settler, or whatever you want, or Second Cry Combo Boss. The reality is that sometimes you just have creatures, and the only creatures is too bad. It's just like unlimited. You want to have interaction. You want to have cheap interaction. And even if Starfire is like not great, because of course it's just a shock, it's actually very good if you just draw it for free. Like, can Starfire anything? So. That's why I like 4. I'm not afraid in sideboarding out them often, like. But against creature decks, it's still a very good turn one play against like Mother of Runes or like Delver of Secrets. The deck plays 23 lands. 23 lands are a lot, but this deck really needs lands since we have 4 and 5 drops and a lot of 3 drops. We play 11 Mountain, 4 Cavern, Pendleven, which turned out to be very good with Lackey and tokens. 3 Port and 4 Wasteland Disruptive together with Aether Vial. So a lot of mana source in the deck. Onto the sideboard. The sideboard, I'm really unsure about it. I used to have Bloodmoon for a while and now I cut it. We have a little bit of Reanimator Hate. Pithy Needle, which is good against Equipment or Sneak and Show. Pyrokinesis, again good against creatures. Tuk-Tuk Scrapper, together with the Goblin Trashmaster, we try to again sideboard this in against Stoneforge Mystic. Why not more Trashmaster? Because you probably can have Pithy Needle, and if they name Pithy Needle on Trashmaster, you want to have something that gets out of it. Goblin Tuk-Tuk Scrapper is like a Maniac Vandal that deals damage, but it's a Goblin, so that's why we play this. Goblin Chain Whirler, suddenly plays in the main deck. I feel that without the Umpiromancer around, it's not that much needed anymore. Of course, it can be great in some matchups. That's why it's in the sideboard. Sharpshooter does almost the same. You try to kill one toughness creature, but you can happen to kill also more of those in case you're like Goblin Trashmaster in play. You can just sacrifice goblins and Sharpshooter will untap. Couple of Pyroblast and Red Elemental Blast. I'm not sure if this is right, but we'll try them out. And then I also love to remind you that on ChannelFireball.com they have M19 pre-order, so you can go there and check all the new cards you need, such as a Goblin Trashmaster. And here we are, onto game number one with a... this end is nice. I'm gonna keep this end. We have Wasteland is in interaction with double Goblin Lackey, and if we get lucky, with the lucky. I remember Matt explained to me the difference between lucky and lucky, but I don't remember now. Probably like lucky, it's this, and lucky is if we draw a ringleader. So let's try to get lucky with the lucky. All right, we're in it. Really, we really need to get lucky now. And ringleader. Ringleader. Mountain? No. I guess you could have mulligan and not to have to be lucky, but my hand was, if it worked, it would have been great. On the play with Goblin Lackey, it's very strong. And yeah, let's see, opponent's probably like Jund or stuff like that. They didn't have an answer to the lucky, so that's why I wanted to waste a Badland. They can't have now, like, they can have like Punishing Fire on 2 mana, so I don't want them to reach a second land drop. And I can still top deck like a Ringleader. Or Tar Fire. Actually, well, Scrublin they played. I'm gonna play around Punishing Fire here and not pump. I lose one damage this way, but I save my lucky from a Punishing Fire. I start Fire for the like Dark Confident. Ooh, Polluted Delta. I don't know what's happening now. Really, no, they're not except Polluted Delta, so. Let's just see what's happening. Are they like, I don't know, Faithless Looting? For me, they're Mardu. But the Mardu deck that I recorded with was playing Gitax and Promla. Gitax and Promla was very important there. With like the 3-4. Bedlam Reveler. Discarded two Bloodcasts. Sure, they already made land drop. Come on, I really need to draw... I really need to draw a goblin, like a big goblin here. Not sure if they had to tar fire me. Like, what's my hand that they don't put into play with Lucky? Come on, let's draw a goblin, please. Alright, I guess that qualifies. I might want to pump this time. Since my opponent has to answer the Cranko first. And the one damage can be relevant at this point. So Cranko in the house, and my opponent needs to kill it. I mean, maybe they just get around it with like a sweeper at some point. A not hasty Cranko is not that threatening. Really wish I had like a Ringleader or Siege Gang. This is why I don't like Kikijiki, because there are some games where Kikijiki is insane, and some games where Kikijiki is just a 2-2 for 5. Whereas Siege Gang would have been great. So let's see what they do now. Goblin Bombardment. Oh yeah, that's the deck. I didn't think about it at first, but now it clearly makes sense. And yeah, now the Pendulaven is tapped, so my opponent can't kill the Lucky. Yeah, Goblin Bombardment is now a new deck. It's almost like Goblins. Those decks that I just like raised after the Deathrite-Shaman ban, they just got freed. Discarded Lingering Souls and Polluted Delta. Now I'm gonna probably kill my Lucky and pass. And I can just draw a Ringleader and cast it. So the top deck is still alive. Come on, Ringleader. Even Chieftain or War Chief wouldn't be that bad. Okay, now I can put my opponent down to 5. Maybe it's just better if I just create goblins here. Putting my opponent down to 5, I don't think brings me anywhere. And they leave, maybe I just tap the Cranko. Because if I tap Cranko, my opponent removes it. And I'll put any goblins, so maybe I just make sure to have at least one goblin. Then my opponent can sacrifice the Bloodcast to kill it, and then make a land drop and reanimate both, so I guess I just pass here. I'll tap Bedlin. I think Scrubland is only used for Lingering Souls. So I'll tap Bedlin. And yeah, let's pass. I don't want to make them ever use from Goblin from like a land drop off this Bloodghast. That's why I'm not tapping Cranko. Alright, they go to combat, and I'm definitely gonna take 2. I don't care about blocking this Bloodghast because it comes back from the graveyard if you make a land drop, so. I mean, it's not sure that they have a land drop to make. Okay. Yeah, sure. So the Cranko is probably gonna die to this Bloodghast. Undiscovered Paradise combos very well with Bloodghast. If you tap it during your untap step, next untap step, you return Undiscovered Paradise. So this is where you make sure that you have unlimited Bloodghasts. Alright, I'm gonna create the Cranko right now so that they can't kill Cranko in response when I tap it. Now I just have a goblin. It's rough. It's rough. My opponent has Lingering Souls in the graveyard. It's very rough. This card is just 2 damage only, so it's still a 3/3, so I can't pump it. Cranko's dead. And Lingering Souls isn't coming. They have 2 cards in hand. They can also just flashback looting. I don't know what their hand about. Carrion Feeder. Alright. Sacrifice a creature and put a 1/1 counter on Carrion Feeder. So again, Bloodghast going off with Undiscovered Paradise. Yeah, very, very little synergies, as I said. But definitely get in there. Whereas we are definitely flooded, but our hand was 5 lands, so. Yeah. Another Warchief not doing much. I wish I drew it the turn before, because I could have made 2 goblins a hasty. Now we play. I mean, what do we even play? If you play Warchief and attack, I'm going to just suck 2 on these and just block. So, not even sure. I want to play the Warchief. Also because my opponent has Bloodghasts, so they can just kill my old board all the time. Yeah. I might attack and trade these 2 spirits for 2 counters against this goblin, but I'll just pass here. I mean, I'm gonna lose, like, I'm totally losing this game. But I might draw, like, Siege Gang Commander or stuff like that. Maybe be back in game, but I'm really not sure about it. Yeah, and this is a combo. So Bloodghasts now. Luckily, they're not hasty. To be hasty, I have to be under 10 life. But at some point, I will, since Carrion Feeder is definitely beating. That's funny, because it's just a 1/1 zombie, but can grow very, very fast. Gravecrawler also comes off with this. You can cast it from your graveyard, and this is a zombie. This is a vampire, though. So Gravecrawler says, you may cast it from a graveyard if you control a zombie. So yeah, I guess I basically locked out of the game here. But it doesn't want to suck onto the Carrion Feeder because they want to kill my goblin, my token. Because they can sacrifice Bloodghast to kill the goblin, they can pump with Pendulum and they sacrifice in response. Or they sacrifice the Gravecrawler, sure. So so that they can play in second main phase using the Discover Paradise. Yeah, I mean, that definitely, that deck is definitely fun. We didn't function very well, but I'm happy. I'm happy my opponent got to have fun. And I guess now even Siege Gang doesn't do anything anymore. Oh, true. Yeah. Earthcrawler really going off now. Alright, we can see 23 lands are a lot, but again, we kept on 5. We couldn't mulligan, but this hand could have gone totally different had we. Alright, so definitely Sharpshooter and Goblin Tree and Whirler. Very, very easy in. Pity Needle also seems very good. And what else? Surgical Extraction might be strong. Maybe Relic. Brought in a lot of non-goblins, so I should consider siding out Ringleader. Not sure about those Pyrokineses. Not sure about those. Alright, what do we want to cut? Can cut a bunch of Ringleader, just because that will be way worse. Now, I can cut... Tarfire does look great at all, like, they do have Carrion Feeder that I can kill, but it is not, I can't even kill it sometimes. I'm gonna just leave a Gem Pump Incinerator as a removal spell. What else do we want? I might just cut all the Ringleaders. I don't know. My deck has become way different now with this to name like Bombardment or Carrion Feeder to stop them, with Surgical in order to stop Gravecrawler or Bloodgust or even Lingering Souls. And we are Relic, of course, very, very strong. What do we want to cut? Maybe Warchief, since my mana cost has been reduced. I'm gonna cut Warchief. And yeah, let's just go with this. Game number 2 on the play, let's see what we got. We got a pretty slow one. And I believe we have 2 mulligan at this end. We do have Surgical Extraction, which is strong. We might keep based on these two, but I'm gonna just ship these. Alright, this is a keep. We have a turn 1 Lackey. Probably Matron on top, and I kinda like it. What if my opponent just kills the Goblin Lackey? Then I need to draw land. Maybe I should just bottom this Matron. Do I might find myself? I guess with Goblin Matron, I can just put this in with Pithy Needle, and then with Goblin Lackey, and then put in Siege Gang, and then I'll be good. See if they have a failed push or whatever for my Goblin Lackey. If they do, I'm happy I bottom that Goblin Matron. Stitcher Supplier. Alright. When enter the battlefield or dies, you mill 3. And then mill 2 Gravecrawler. And then mill through 2 Gravecrawler. Sorry. Okay. So, it's a 1-1. So I can now cycle. I'm gonna play a Mountain just to make them know that we don't have a Pain 11 open. And this way, I get to connect with my Goblin Lackey. My opponent's gonna mill 3 more cards. I thought this is very good against Goblin Matron. Yeah, now, since I bottomed that Matron with my Scry, I kinda... Huh. I can get Ringleader, but again, we don't have that many target anymore. Maybe I just get Siege Gang. I just got Siege Gang gear. So the Gravecrawler don't block. Just like the Bloodgusts. Stitcher Supplier. Alright, there's a Lingering Souls, but again, they can't do it now. I decided to take a Siege Gang because I also had a 4 mana in my hand, 4 lands in my hand. So we can easily Arcast this. Ooh, Gurmagangler. I didn't see this. And we boarded out Sting Scourger. Yeah, definitely with teacher supplier, you're making them strong. Okay, more goblin matron. I cannot attack anymore. But it won't be. So, what do we want to take with Goblin Matron? I can't take Chain Whirler. Or maybe Sharpshooter. I guess I'll take Sharpshooter here. How do I deal with the Gurmagangler? I can just double block. I can deal one damage, and two trigger dies, two and three. Yeah, I guess Sharpshooter can do pretty broken stuff. And also my opponent has to be afraid of attacking with the Gurmag, because then the Goblin Lackey can't get through. Alright, Goblin Bombardment. Okay, so this Pithy Needle will definitely be cast now. And if my opponent doesn't do anything now, I'll just have Pendulaven in play. Alright. Upkeep. Ooh. Okay, that's good. Let's just play Pendulaven. And then my opponent cannot kill any of my creature because it can pump. It cannot respond to a land drop. My opponent couldn't know about this. Of course. So the Pithy Needle now being great. So naming Goblin Bombardment. And now opponent cannot use this. And maybe I just tap out to play the Sharpshooter. The Sharpshooter is definitely strong, and my opponent and I also will not have protection for Pendulaven, but I don't think my opponent has like shocks or stuff like that, and they need to get my Sharpshooter alive, like going, let's say. We still have the Siege Gang in hand. Opponent with only two lands, they can flashback this, they can cast those Grave Crawlers since Stitcher supplies a zombie, and also Gurmagangler. Okay, more Stitcher Supplier, that's fine. They milled the Cabal Therapy. Wow, they knew about my Siege Gang, so that's definitely a strong mill, the Cabal Therapy. And I'm probably gonna lose the Siege Gang now. Okay, Great Cry from the Graveyard, and this is leaving. Oh, maybe opponent forgot that they knew about the Siege Gang. They should definitely discard it. If they don't, and I draw land, I'm jamming the Siege Gang. Okay. So with my Sharpshooter now, I can pick apart my opponent's board. And that's strong. That's definitely strong. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. And I'm also going to cast this Mogwar Marshal so that in my upkeep when this dies, I can just use Sharpshooter more times. Yeah, let's play those two Mogwar Marshals and pass. Not actually, I'm gonna use the Sharpshooter right now to kill these. So Sharpshooter doing great stuff. I'm gonna mill my opponent deck, and of course that's not really what you wanna do, but since I have Sharpshooter in play, I can just take I have control over all the blood gusts and stuff like that, and I just want to kill my opponent's creature in case they draw like a Carrion Feeder. Or I mean, they want to use it their Cabal Therapy in the graveyard. They can still have like random Grave Crawler Cabal Therapy, but they maybe just forgot about Siege Gang. To a Sharpshooter, ooh, all right, Pithy Needle is unfortunate. We do have a Goblin Trashmaster in our deck. Gonna deal one damage to him. And Goblin Trashmaster, we can just sacrifice a goblin. We don't have to sacrifice itself. Goblin Trashmaster also pumping the team. Very, very strong. Angry Crow from the graveyard. Sure. I'm gonna pay the eco, I think. So if I attack with all. Yeah, I'm gonna pay the eco. Sure. Like, it's bad if I draw land. But if I don't draw land. Like, This is a long game, so might as well just get the value from my Mogwart Marshals. Alright, if I attack with all, my opponent takes 6 and kills the Lackey. And goes to 10. Yeah, I mean, 10 is not much. Siege Gang is gonna come down later. Yeah, I'm just gonna attack with all. Okay. Gummy Sharpshooter is on top now. Alright, 2 spirits in play. Gummy Sharpshooter would be great. They attack, I take 2. Goblin Matron, so now I can get my thing. The question is, do I want to do it? Maybe yes. I mean, if I cast Siege Gang, so if I attack with all, they block 3, they take 4, they go to 6. 6 is still quite a lot. I mean, Siege Gang makes it so that they die next turn, though they have Stingering Souls. Maybe I just go for Goblin Matron. Goblin Matron for... where is it? Goblin Trashmaster. Ooh, now, oh wait, they have Cabal Therapy, I forgot about it. I definitely forgot about it. Alright. Huh. I guess I should have just played Siege Gang. I forgot about the Cabal Therapy. As much as my opponent forgot about it, I also forgot about it. At this point, I'm kind of committing to attack. I'm gonna pump a Matron just to make it survive. I think it works more than the 1 point. Yes, my opponent could have gone down to 5, but it is also strong. Yeah, kind of regretting it, but that's okay. Yeah, now my opponent can just flashback the Cabal Therapy for free with the Blood Gust, since they can then fetch. Like, yeah, of course I changed my plan going through, and it was definitely bad. I should have just played Siege Gang Commander. I forgot about the Cabal Therapy, and at that point I was forced into attacking with Thoughtseize. Wow. And at that point I was forced into attacking with a Sharpshooter too. But I concede he's at 3 and he's just dead on board. I don't know why that did like this, but yeah, it doesn't matter. We were very high. My opponent was on 2 land for the whole game. Alright. So we decided to be less like goblin functional and more like sideboard hate, and the sideboard hate definitely was great. Pithidin was great. We also had these. I don't think I want to have Scrapper though. Like, we saw Pithy Needle, but that was about it. And I think I'm happy with this. Yeah, let's just submit again. Maybe I want to have Sting Scourger, since my opponent has a Gurmagangler. Though my opponent has so many cards in the graveyard that bouncing Gurmagangler is not that effective. So maybe I don't want Sting Scourger just for like 2, maybe 3 Gurmagangler. So let's just submit this. This end is indeed slow and without a 1 drop, without sideboard hate. I'm gonna mulligan this end. We're gonna keep... Ooh, Chain Whirler. Chain Whirler is strong. Double red, triple red is a problem with this deck since we only have like 15 sources. But we do have also Aether Vial and Goblin Lackey to cast it. Stitcher Supplier is a good start. Ooh, meaning Zealous Persecution. I'm going to just play Goblin Lackey. And let's see what's next. No land? Ooh, attack. Alright. I guess they have a removal spell from a Goblin Lackey. Oh, Goblin Bombardment. Sure. Alright, they milled a Grave Crawler. And I'm going to Pithy Needle Goblin Bombardment, and I'm not going to Wasteland. I'm not going to Wasteland because I need my land. I even drew a 5 drop now. Put them board anywhere there to deal with my Pithy Needle. So right now they don't have any synergy in the graveyard, just one Grave Crawler, but they need to have a zombie in play. Hopefully they don't have a Gormagangler. That'll be very hard to deal with. Stitcher Supplier. I don't know why they fetch first. They could have waited in case they milled the Blood Gust. And Bitter Blossom. Sure. Ooh, Goblin Matron. Maybe I'm just casting Chieftain here. Just casting Chieftain and getting aggressive with my Chieftain. I can then cast Goblin Matron and attack with that too. Getting whatever I want. Maybe just Sharpshooter. The fact that Sharpshooter is hasty is way better than a non-hasty Sharpshooter. Never started with Aether Vial, that's definitely something. I also mulligan them very often, maybe game 1 should have mulligan too. Alright, opponent with the board, but only one X1, so if I draw a land for Chain Whirler, that's just great. But there's not many of those. Alright, let's cast Goblin Matron. It's very important not to wasteland with this deck if you don't have vials or stuff like that. Let's get Goblin Sharpshooter. And pass. I don't want to trade Goblin Matron. I have Sharpshooter in my hand. My opponent really needs to find a Thought Seize Orc about therapy now. And I just have this Chain Whirler also chilling in there. Though, as I said, it's not that easy to cast it. That's why it's in the sideboard, because, yeah. Because you can't really cast this with Goblin Lackey, since the decks you're boarding this in will have blockers. Yeah, I don't want to block anything. By anything, I mean just this, because the other fly. I have two answer for older board, so I just hope my opponent passes here. Maybe they have some more X1s in hand. Hopefully they have some more Goblin Bombardments in hand. Alright, fifth land. And pass. Okay, let's cast this Goblin Sharpshooter. And let's start to... kill all the things. See if it works. Or if my opponent is gonna kill a Sharpshooter in response. No? Alright. Let's just do it all now. Since my opponent made me on top, I'm quite positive they didn't have it. Like, they don't have anything. So let's just kill everything and then attack. I can even attack with the Sharpshooter itself. No, I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it because my opponent is gonna have a Bitter Blossom token and they have a zombie, also Grave Crawler, so I just want to just be able to untap with the Goblin Sharpshooter effectively, because this Sharpshooter does not untap on itself. It needs a creature to die in order to untap. Alright, opponent definitely is flooding out and didn't really function a lot, but also because we had the Pithy Needle. Like, sideboarding Pithy Needle was huge. So, yeah, this Sharpshooter just wins the match. Goblin Chainwearer would have been great as well, but yeah, Sharpshooter costing better mana is just a deal. Alright, we are off a good start, and we'll be back for round number 2. Alright, round number 2, we got a Vial this time. If we wanted to play, maybe we should have just led with Goblin Lackey. We are on the draw though, so let's just have more information about what's our opponent playing. They're playing Underground Sea Ponder, so this might mean combo, and then I definitely need to play Lackey. This also might mean Grace's Control, and then it's better to get a Vial in play. They choose to not shuffle. But I think I'm just gonna go for the Lackey. Not expecting a Wasteland. But I mean I can more expect like a Daze or like even a Force of Will. If they don't have any way to deal with Lackey. But I'm expecting more of a combo deck now. Nowadays, playing, so yeah, maybe a Stoneblade. Stoneforge Mystic's in. And yeah, I guess I'm gonna play. It's pretty bad to go Steam Scourger. But that'll mean that Goblin Matron gets in. What did I get? Mazel's Cheetah. With Goblin Matron, I can just get a Trash Master. Or maybe I'll get a Palma Gem. A Gem Palm. Gem Palm means that. Gem Palm means that. The question is, do I want to Steam Scourger that Stoneforge Mystic? That's my whole thing. Then I go Goblin Matron. What can I get? I guess I get Aesthetic Trash Master. Yeah, this way the Aether Vial is gonna be pretty bad, unfortunately. We should just let it with that. Because Steel Scourger is just a bounce spell now. Act like a bounce spell. My opponent is gonna replay the Stoneforge Mystic, get Bodice. Cool, then what do? We just play our things. And then on turn 4 I can Trash Master. Yeah, maybe that's not that bad actually. Let's just go for it. Goblin Trash Master. Now they're forced into replaying a Stoneforge Mystic. In my upkeep, I will not pay Eco for the Steam Scourger. And then I also have some good draws. I can draw a Tarfire. I can draw a Palma Gem. Those would be like all insane draws. Because they will let me cast, like put into play another Goblins. But probably I'll just put into play a Mogwai Marshal to play around Plow on the Thrashmaster. Tough game. I could have also just played Mogwai Marshal and pass. Monster Mentor, interesting. Alright, we don't pay. And we draw Champ on Incinerator. That's a good draw. So yeah, just let's go for it. I guess I opponent cannot daze anything. There's no spell on the stack. So yeah, this was the nuts basically. And do I want to Wasteland or just play Aether Vial? I guess I'll waste. Can I want to play Aether Vial? Because I really want to use the fourth mana to cast Thrashmaster next turn. Yeah. Though, if I Wasteland them, they replay Stoneforge in this kind of the same situation. So I'm better off in just playing Vial here. And I kind of wish maybe I took Goblin Ringleader. But of course, I couldn't know I would have drawn a Monster Man, Gem Palm Incinerator. And now, yeah, playing Wasteland is an option. Using Wasteland is an option, but again, if my opponent just plays a Stoneforge Mystic, I have to cast Trap Goblin Thrashmaster next turn. To just get him for with the team. Ooh, Inquisition of Cause is like way worse than Thoughts is now. since, yeah, they don't lose two life, but they don't get to take my Thrashmaster. I don't like Inquisition. This is also bad against the Stoneforge that gets Battle School. I think that in Legacy, you need to play Thoughtseize. I guess Nika Show, Inquisition is not even like that good since it takes only Show and Tell from like the combo piece. Our opponent did not shuffle, but they will shuffle now with the Stoneforge. So let's see if we top deck again. Another Jam Pump would be just huge. Mm-hmm. So Stoneforge is in. They got Powder School this time. Not gonna pay Eco. So yes on this and no on that. And draw. What do we draw? Another Wasteland. Interesting. So if I use both of the Wastelands, I can't play Thrashmaster next turn. And again, that's what I wanna do. But if I play Thrashmaster now, I probably can just plow it. Now I needed to draw like a goblin here. If I draw a goblin, opponent's kinda forced into chump blocking the Goblin Lackey. Whereas now, they can just take 8, go to 8, and then just plow the Thrashmaster, put into play Battle School and win. So maybe I need to Wasteland now and pass. That's kinda huge though. That's kinda huge. Put them with 5 cards in their hand. Huh. This is a tough game. I think I have to take it slower. If I just play Thrashmaster attack when it goes to 8 and then they have a plow, I'm dead. Because I can't deal with the equipment. So I'm just playing Cavern of Souls, naming goblins. Wastelanding their Tundra and passing the turn. Not expecting him to turn from their deck. Yeah. Alright, cast a Brainstorm. So they clearly have some sort of removal spell. The problem is that my creature is too weak to just deserve a removal spell. This Thrashmaster in my hand could have been a Ring Leader. And I could have played it last turn, though maybe I would have just missed with it. Or just, you know, not getting enough of what I need. Which is, in this case, just Thrashmaster for their equipment. Oh, they didn't find a land. Okay. So it's our turn. And we pick up with Aether Vial. We draw Goblin Warchief. So we can put that into play now. Is it even effective? Because if I put in Vials in Umezawa's Jeet and then I keep the Stoneforge attacks, they get to kill two things, the Warchief and the Lackey most likely. But I guess I'm happy with that. Because they have to put into play. They have to put into play Jitten now if they want to do it. And if they do, the Goblin Lackey connects. And they can put Thrashmaster into play and kill the Jitten. So they're kind of forced into putting Battle School into play. But then I can just do nothing, pass. I don't really care about the 4 life. My opponent doesn't have a land on top, like in their 8 cards. 6 in hand and 2 on top. Wow. They didn't violin, keep back, put in with Stoneforge an equipment. They want to leave mana up for plow. And I'm just attacking for 2 here. Putin will very likely just plow this. Bitter Blossom. Wow, so many Bitter Blossom. Okay, what do we draw? Fire's going up. Tarfire. Alright. They can very well have a force of will for the Starfire. Yeah, and they force. So I'm just passing. Unfortunately, Cavern of Souls only puts into play spell. Creature uncounterable. Strashmaster still in my hand, and the threat is here. These two equipments are the threat. Okay, so my opponent drew the top two cards, so now they can draw land. The fight's gonna go up. I have three mana, so ooh, Ringleader. Yeah, let's put a Ringleader into play, shall we? I'll do it. Even if my opponent can put it into play with Mazavajit and then keep it on the Fairy Rogue, I can find Tarfire or Goblin Jampal. And that won't work anymore. And does he need to do something? So yeah, Goblin Lackey. So my opponent knows my hand. And I just attack. No, I can't attack with a Ringleader since my opponent can't have Battle School. So yeah, I'll just pass, leaving Tarfire up to kill the Fairy Rogue. If gets equipped with Umezawa's Jita. I don't want to put into play a Trashmaster with no equipments into play. I don't just want it to get destroyed before getting value. Now I can't do it. But I can have 3 mana up to return the Battle School, but that means that they can never tap out, basically. The bias is on 4, and I can just instant speed whenever I want. This is a good game. Ringleader could have gone better, but we just got 2-1 drop, and as I said, Tarfire, very important. Opponent now wanted to get out of the Brainstorm Lock, and tries to hit a land drop with this Ponder. Let's see. They do not shuffle. Okay, so they found a land drop. And they pass. Oh, they attack, of course. Alright, sure, I'll take 4. And what do we draw? So the Vi is gonna stay on 4. Jump on Incinerator. That's a good one. I can kill the Germ. Yeah, let's kill the Germ. If I do that though, I can't tar fire, but I have a Trashmaster, so that's fine. I have Trashmaster up. I kill the Germ so I don't have to play this Trashmaster until my opponent plays the Umezawa's Jita. Mogwai Marshall. I guess I'll trade. I'll trade with those two Fairy Rogues. If I play once a double block, I can also just violin a Thrashmaster. It's not the worst either. I wanted to use this Gem Pond. I could have maybe killed a Stoneforge, but then... I think I'll do it. I think I'll violin Thrashmaster. Though then I might have trouble in dealing with Umezawa's Jita. I'll just trade, that's fine. It's not a great trade, maybe I shouldn't have done it. Yeah, it's probably not a great trade here. Basically, I don't want to ever cast this Trashmaster until my opponent put into play their Umezawa's Jita. And they don't, because I have it. It's kind of a tall situation where I can tap my mana maybe better, I think, because I vial. Lancia's on 4. Goblin Matron is taken. And I think I'm gonna start with Dark Firing this Stoneforge Mystic. And then I can attack with my Goblin Lackey, since I cleared the path the turn before. One is dying, but the other is going to put into play Goblin Matron, that's going to get a Ringleader. So that end of turn I can cast a Ringleader with the Vial, and I can... or always having Trashmaster up. This game is very hard. I might have made some mistakes, but I think overall it's been a good strategy. Alright, Snapcaster Mage is something. Brainstorm, not Plow. I was expecting Plow. To go after my Goblin Lackeys, I can put into play Trashmaster to save one Lackey. And maybe it's time to do it. Maybe it's time to do it. They're also getting for six. Maybe it's time to do it. Opponent is flashbacking Brainstorm, not Plow. Maybe it's time to do it. Opponent is very... Yeah. Alright. Let's put into play this Trashmaster. Okay. Opponent wants to Plow the Trashmaster. Yeah, they do. Okay, it means that they don't flashback. They don't flashback Brainstorm. Yes. It wasn't that effective. I played basically my whole game around this situation, but now my opponent is under some pressure. I mean, they have Bitter Blossoms, but they might need to block every time. They play their Jita. They can equip. Yeah, maybe. Let me just. No. And no. What do we draw? Siege Gang Commander. Alright, what do I want to do here? Once I'm just going to kill two goblins, I can just get Crank on my boss instead of Ringleader. Ringleader can tutor up more interaction like Tarfire. There are two Tarfire left and two Gem Pulp, I think. Yeah, I'm going to just get a Crank on my boss and pass the turn. Yeah. Pass. Opponent now will attack me. Again, this is bad against Plow. Opponent already played two. They won card in hand, they drew a second one. This is a tough game. I don't know, maybe I shouldn't have played Trashmaster there, but playing Trashmaster meant that they had to have a Plow, they could have also not have it. And they didn't play their Brainstorm because of that. So Jita charges. They will move Jita maybe. They don't. Alright, let's play Cranko here. What do they do? Vendilion click? Oh, I got punished for not main phasing my Cranko. Can you still draw Ringleader? No, Mountain. Okay. Why is it gonna go up? And I'll attack with all. If my opponent is killing a goblin, I can in response violate the siege gang and use that goblin to deal him damage. They just block, that's fine. They take 4 down to 5. The Umazawa Jita can also gain life. Really does everything right now. Alright, I'll do this. I really need my opponent to use Jita here. They use Jit is great. The fact that they know about the siege game makes them not use Jit, of course. So they're playing tight there. If I cast my siege gang... Ooh, actually... Are they dead? They kinda are, right? I'm gonna put into play siege gang now, so that if they have Snapcaster Mage, they can go Snapcaster Plow. Because they can't really... Huh. Do I want to cast his Mogul Marshal or not? That's the question. I don't think so. So if I put into play Siege Gang now, they go down to 4. I can deal them 4, go to 1, and they need to gain life before the Bitter Blossom resolves. And then they can attack, pitch it up to 3, and kill my Siege Gang. And kill a Goblin, but they will still be on 3 life. If I cast this Mogwar Marshal now, I will have 2 more power. Yeah, maybe I'll just cast this Mogwar Marshal here and don't kill them. Okay. I pass. Can I have another Vendilion Click this way though? Maybe I'm just supposed to use Vial now. Maybe I should have just used it in my turn. I don't know why I waited. Please don't have a Vial. Don't have another Rendeal Click. Okay. So, Siege Gang's coming in. With the team. And I let them draw a card. This is a lot of goblins. They need to, like... I don't know, hopefully they don't have Supreme Verdict. I should have just end phase for Supreme Verdict. Okay. Council Judgment. What do I want to kill here? So they definitely want to kill Siege Gang. They have 0 cards in them, so maybe I can figure this out. So, with Umezawa's Jite, I deal 2 to them with my Siege Gang, but then they exile the Mogwar Marshal. Yeah, sure, whatever. I deal 2 to them. And so if I kill Mogwar Marshal, they need to kill Siege Gang and I get an extra goblin. Whereas this way, if I sacrifice Mogwar Marshal, they exile my Mogwar So now it's about these two. I have to sacrifice a goblin. I think I'll sacrifice Mogwar Marshal because I create an extra goblin. I'll have 9 goblin and they exile this. If I sacrifice a siege gang, they just exile goblin Mogwar Marshal and I don't get any goblin. So I'll sacrifice this goblin. Put him down to 2. And now they exile my Mogwar Marshal. My siege gang commander. I have 9 goblins. They can kill 4 down to 5, block 1 and lose. So I should have won this game. Very, very tight game. Siege Gank dies. Very, very tight game. Pharaoh can stay back, but no, it can't. It has to attack. So this can kill 4. They block 1, and they take 4. They can gain life. They can gain 8 life up to 10, and they can survive. Sure. Okay. Oh, and they move Jit. Maybe I should have just killed this rogue. That was a mistake. That was maybe a mistake. I should have just killed the rogue. I forgot about the life gain. So I attack with all now. And I guess I also play Aether Vial. Wow. I should have just killed the Fairy Rogue. If I kill the Fairy Rogue, my opponent gains 8, but they don't charge Umezawa's Jita, whereas now they do. I only thought about just them killing my things and not gaining life. But that was definitely a thing. So they go up to 10, they take 8, they go down to 2, and they charge it. We're playing bad, guys. We're playing bad. We navigated this game very well up to this point, I think. Opponent's on 2 and the Jita's charged. They go down to 1 in upkeep. I keep Fairy Rogue Attack. I think anything but him was good with the Siege Gang. Even like, no, actually, you know, I should have just killed the Fairy Rogue and tapped. Now they move the G10. And what do I draw? Come on, deck, give me something good. Give me something good. Gem Palm Incinerator. Alright. My opponent can pump this Fairy Rogue up to a 9/9. But then if they do, the GT has zero counter, so I just attack it all. So I'm just gonna cycle, pay 2, and deal damage to this. Right? Yeah. This was a great draw. Maybe we got out now. Opponent should be dead at this point, because they can't gain. Alright, it's pumping it. It's pumping it. Why are they pumping it? Alright, I can see it. Ooh, what a game, what a game. That was something, that was something. Really interesting, really, really intricate game. We had the line with Siege Gang. We had the game a couple of turns ago with perfect information. We missed it. That was pretty bad, but we recovered it by top decking this Gem Palm. Really, really great game. Okay, so those two comes in. Opponent only has Bitter Blossom. They also have Monster Mentor. I think that'll be it. I guess Tuck Scrapper for sure. I'm boarding out Sting Scourger again. Not sure about this Crankomaw boss. I think I'm boarding it out. And I'm keeping it all the Tar Fire since my opponent has Stoneforge Mystic. Oh, they also have Bandit Lock Lake. So yeah, these two definitely be good. Alright, let's go. Okay, we got a keep. Not exciting end, but it's a keep. Well, I just realized that we are pretty low on time. Ooh, Cavern of Souls off the top. I don't think my opponent left in a removal spell. Sorry, a counter magic. But still, having Ringleader and the Goblin and the Cavern of Souls is huge. Lucky's probably getting plowed. Okay. Basic Island and Baleful Strix. Sure, another X1. I'm not gonna kill it. I'm not gonna play Wasteland. I need all my lands. This deck, Wasteland's very late in the game. I'm not even sure if you should play Wasteland. Maybe just more useful land like Caracas or Pendlehaven are just better than Wasteland. I mean, I guess Wasteland is good because they can have like Tabernacle or Grove of the Burning Willows, and you want to get out of these and appear Dark Depths. But maybe we're Shadow Port. It should just be like a 2 of. I don't know. I don't really find myself in using Wasteland a lot with this deck. So Thoughtseize. They're maybe getting a Ringleader now. The shifting is not that great. The fact my opponent played the turn 2 Baleful Strix might mean that they don't have Stoneforge, so if they don't make a play now, ooh, they discarded Tar Fire. Sure. Oh, I see why. Okay, Goblin Matron is a good draw. I'll take Tuk Tuk Scrapper. I think I want to get a 2-for-1 instead of just So it's gonna be much one. Yes, get the Tuk Tuk Scrapper. My opponent will get to kill the Goblin Matron, but that doesn't really matter. We got rid of Umazavajit, and that's what it matters. Opponent also plays plays a mix of Thoughtseize and an Inquisition. Let's see if they have a Snapcaster Mage. They go for Brainstorm first. Stick and go land Snapcaster Thoughtseize. That'll be bad. It's like really false to this effect. Maybe I should have just boarded the NPC needle. I also said that in the recording, in the deck tech, but then I just didn't board the NPC needle, which I should have definitely done. Maybe over like one tar fire and something else. Let's see what this ponder do. No shuffle. Okay, did they find a Thoughtseize? Target player's got two cards. Against Red Eye for each land discarded this way. Alright. Discard Chieftain for sure, and I guess Ringleader. I can't afford to miss a land drop here. And with a Ringleader in my hand, I'll just have a card advantage for next turn. Garar's Verdict. Interesting card. Take, I'll play, sure, Wasteland, and Tick Tick Scrapper. Dealing my opponent 2 damage because that's what the Tick Tick Scrapper does, and attack for 1. If the opponent does an upcaster Gerard's Verdict, we are in Hellbent. Could have played Pandalaven over Wasteland, but opponent doesn't know about the Pandalaven that they knew about the Wasteland. What did this ponder do? Not shuffle, but then they shuffle with the Flawless Strand. Let's see. Snapcaster Gerard's Verdict. All right. Also gained 6 in the process since I discarded. Oh, no, I guess I didn't discard land last turn. Yeah, now I wish I had a Pendleven in play rather than a Wasteland. Maybe I should have just done that. Alright, so kind of an Imp to Turek acting on here. And the opponent does not want to trade. Aether Vial, not great. And yeah, I mean, I could have topped another land. And I don't want to offer the trade 2-1 with 1-1. Sorry, 2-2 with 2-1. Yep. Stoneforge Mystic. Getting bought is cool. I'll take. We have to draw well here. I think Turing Leader in the bin is a tough one. But there's a third on top, so that's alright. We have to hit good though. So come on deck. Shows us some goodies. Ooh, Trashmaster and Siege Gang. As well as attacking for 4. It's definitely a good hit off my ring lead. I was Hellbent and now I have a totally refilled. Totally refilled. I don't know what my opponent's name, they have Battle School and maybe a removal spell since they never shuffled the ponder and they never played a removal spell thus far. I guess I played one on the Goblin Lackey turn 1. And now they're Brainstorm. Brainstorm particularly good with Stoneforge Mystic deck because you can just have that shuffle effect too. Attack for 1, I'll take. Vial up, and Tar Fire is the draw. I can't really do much. If I cast Trash Master, I'm putting it as a plow, it's bad, so I have to wait on this Trash Master. And I can't cast Siege Gang, so I just pass here. I don't want to trade because I have Trash Master, so I don't want to do any trade here. My opponent will have 3 mana up next turn to return the Vasco, so I can sacrifice another Goblin to get that value. I can just tar fire this Baleful Strix. I think Stoneforge does anything at this point. Like, I guess my opponent can return Battlescale and they have to pay 5 mana. Yeah, I'll take this. Maybe not. Let's kill that. The damage can be annoying at some point. I could have also drawn like a Chain Whirler and deal with that way. Aether Vial, yes. Cavern of Souls to draw. I guess I'll play my Siege Gang Commander and pass. But I can kill this, and that's fine. I could also just wait for Vial on 5 to do Siege Gang with 4 activation up. Opponent needs to brainstorm after, or needs to fetch after the brainstorm. Ooh, Creeping Tar Pit. But in the face of Siege Gang Commander, it's not that threatening. But also, I have a Wasteland play. And I kinda don't need lands anymore, so I can start Wastelanding. It's kinda counterintuitive. The fact that I. Okay, Zeal's Persecution. That's a good one. It's definitely a good one. And it's in with the team. So I'll take 10. I can't take 10. Alright, Zeal's Persecution was a beating. We'll try to recover. So Vi's gonna go on 4. Yeah, I need to draw like Mogwar Marshal. Mogwar Marshal would be a good draw. So that I can use them to either Siege Gang and Trash Master. Champ on Machine later. Yeah, I guess I'll cycle the champ on to kill a Snapcaster Mage. Drew Mountain. Play my Mountain. I can't violate the Trash Master and kill the Germ. Sorry, and kill the Bioscope, sacrificing 2 goblins. Huh. That's tough. I didn't notice my time is ticking down, so. Yeah, I kinda never time out, but this deck is really making me think a lot. So I'll three, six. Yeah, I kinda have to. Yes. Return, and then destroy. So I have to suck this, then return it, suck this in response, then return it, and suck this, and they'll, yeah. Guess that's what I have to do. And then can Wasteland the Creeping Tar Pit. It's gonna be a. Pretty bad. Maybe I should have done it in my turn, and I remember. I thought I needed to sacrifice one less goblin. It's definitely not a good spot for me. Can still recover with some top decks. I kinda need to like concede at some point. Definitely play super fast. I have 422 and they have to play game 3 if I lose this. The creeping tar pit was what, sorry, the Zeus persecution was what threw me down. I should have maybe waited for Violon 5. Should have definitely waited for Violon 5. If I have wave with Violon 5, I have mana up, so anything happens, I can use. Yeah, I definitely punted. This deck is hard to do. Is hard to play. Ringleader. This deck is hard to play. Ooh. Yeah, should have just put it to play with Vile, but I already clicked on it. I really can lose life. I really can lose time. Mogwai Marshals. And now I get kind of screwed because I can't put into play both. But that's okay. Again, it's all about the time. It's all about the time here, boys and girls. .350, we have plenty of time to finish this game, but the fact that we were so behind, now my opponent break the, like, 5 turns in a row is making me back into this game. Yeah. Had I Violin, I would have had a Mogwai Marshal in play. Not that it's that relevant because my opponent doesn't want to, but still. They attack a double block. Snap off a double block. So, no. Pay Eco. Yes. Draw. Shadow Board. I don't care about tapping. I really can't lose time at this point. They have something. Zeus persecution again. Sure. I killed all my board. I go out down to 1. What did I draw? Disenchant. Not sure if disenchant is effective against me. I only have Vile. Actually, I'm gonna kill Caracas. My opponent can have some legends that want to return. Alright, Stoneforge. They should have run out of equipment. Both G10 and Battle School are in the bin. Okay, I'll chomp here. Bitter Blossom. Alright, I can still draw Ringleader. Warchief. Still something. Can still draw Ringleader and maybe get out of this. Alright, Jace. Okay. We have 3 minutes. I could have conceded 1 minute and a half ago. I'm gonna have just one piece of needle. That's why they have disenchant, I guess. I'm gonna cut one tar fire. Sure. Let's breathe and let's take our time. And let's go down to game 3 with three minutes on the clock. On the play, with a keep, is this a keep? I don't know. No turn one play is very sad. Maybe I should have just mulliganed. I'm really thinking very little. Not that I think a lot the other times, but now I'm really thinking very little. I have to make all my decisions super fast. Super mega fast. Swamp and Thoughtseize. Maybe saying goodbye to Mogwai Marshal. Now I can either... Ooh, Gem Palm. Okay. Yeah, Mogwai Marshal is not that great if they have Stoneforge Mystic now. All right, so dump a eco. Having drawn to our fire is definitely good. No. Okay, land please. No land, very sad. Alright, land now. I can, yeah, I guess I'll get my Goblin Trashmaster out. Where is it? Here. I get my Goblin Trashmaster out. Opponent will Jita Keep. Or maybe just they pass, draw land. I'll cast Ring Leader. Thinking very little at this point. Any order, pass. They can have like a Thoughtseize, a Snapcaster Mage. Many things they can have. Or okay, I was expecting a Hazelius Persecution and was about to concede, but actually, you know, let's just play this out. Inquisition again, saving my Trashmaster. All right. So, I'll, I don't know what to do, Let's jump on first. Kill a Stoneforge Mystic. So that they can't, just vial and do annoying stuff. And then let's play this. And pass. Stoneforge Mystic again. Okay, it's not that great, but sure, it's something. Block. Cavern of Souls, naming goblins. What do I play? Play War Chief. And pass. Could have played the Chieftain. Just want to make sure that I don't want to tap. I don't want to lose time. Time is very important now. Chieftain would have been great though. Maybe I was supposed to do that. Four goblins in front of the germ. Sharpshooter. And let's attack. I'm not sure if this is the right sequencing. Opponent is on 28, they could just take here. I mean, they should just take here. Okay, I can just block the Continuum Priest and kill it, I guess. Baleful Strix. That's gonna die. And what else? If they attack, I can trade the Containment Priest with the Goblin Matron so they don't attack. Wasteland. Let's play Chain Whirler. Sharpshooter will clear the board. We might win this game. And then I can't attack here. I can't attack because Zeus persecution. I guess now I lose. Okay. Your turn is a 5/5. And then they have a third land. I will tap a land. I have 10 seconds on the clock. Jeez. Thresh Monster. One second on the clock. Wow, the seconds really go down very fast. Yeah, I guess I lose at this point. They also have GT plus true name, so I would have lost no matter what. Oh, this was a good game. This was a good game. Game two, we could have won, I guess. But yeah, this was definitely a good game to show. Those two matches were insane. I lost for 1 minute on the clock, so I could have played faster, maybe one per time. And yeah. It's been a good run so far. We're 1-1, and I'd like to remind you that Channel Fireball is the place that ball sends, but also trade cards. So go to channelfireball.com/buylist to trade with them. And yeah, we'll be back for a third round and more with Goblins. Round number 3. With a mountain and an ether vial, will it be good enough? I hope so. I'm keeping this end. Ponder. Alright, I'm gonna say Ponder again. It used to be a way more common play in the past. Legacy. Alright, they shuffled. Drawing mountain is good. It means that if this vial doesn't resolve, we need those mountains. Alright, did resolve. I also have Mogwai Marshals, this way I can curve out a little bit better. Thoughtseize. That's fine, we have 5 spell in hand. Thoughtseize is not gonna have a huge impact on our hand. Especially with cards like Goblin Matron, where I can just drop whatever I want. Is this the same opponent as before? No, it's another. Yeah, I think this might be like Grixis Control. A deck that got really weakened by the essence of Deathrite-Shaman, but still alive. Right up to 2. Draw Goblin Lackey. Wow, opponent's not expecting this. Hopefully they don't have Call Against Command. But if they do have a Call Against Command, maybe they main phase it. So we get to Violent Response Goblin Lackey, and then have Siege Commander. Alright, I pass. Yeah, I'm forced into Violent this Goblin Lackey and get it killed. Oh, we untapped. I'm going to pay the Eco Cost of Mogwai Marshal. If we draw land, it's bad. I guess we drew Wasteland, so it's not that bad. Alright, let's attack with all. Does my opponent have a kill spell for Goblin Lackey? They do. Okay. Gonna destroy the Underground Sea so that my opponent cannot call against Command us next turn. Alright, do they have another cantrip here? They didn't have last turn because they would have played in order to find the third land drop. So maybe a Thoughtseize. Gurmagangler. That's fine. Still pretty good. We can have Sting Scourger in our deck though. Or just in hand at this point. Okay, let's cast this Sting Scourger. They can force this. I mean, they should definitely force this. And they do. Force Speech Spell Pierce.
Sure thing.
They have one land, though. I'm not that afraid of one land. I'm gonna get Ringleader. Put the Vial up to 4. I can also get Cranko, though it might just die and not get me any value. So Vial's gonna go up to 4. I have 2 lands, so any land drop here would be good. I'm gonna Ringleader now, because if I find a Palma Gem, a Gem Palm, I can just, you know, threaten to kill the Gurmag Angler. My opponent can just destroy a Goblin though, and it doesn't die. So maybe I just attack with a Ringleader. And Goblin match. Ringleader. Yeah, Ringleader is okay, I think. Or, you know what? I'm just gonna play Mogwa Marshall. Not in a hurry at all. Does my opponent know about my hand? Okay. In this way, I just don't even have to destroy the Ringleader. I mean, I think at this point we are like almost a lock. Yeah. Okay. Game number 2. Not sure if we need even need to sideboard anything. Pyroblast against Snapcaster Mage looks pretty bad. I can just have Relic of Progenitus over 2 Tower Fire and call it a day. I want to keep Sting Scourger for Gurmag. The Tower Fire doesn't kill that much. It's just a Goblin for a Ringleader, as I said. And everything else looks good. I don't want to have Chain Whirler, even if they have like Baleful Strix, Snapcaster Mage. I think that's still not good enough. And yeah, let's go. Maybe I want to cut Trashmaster. Though again, no, they might have some annoying artifacts post sideboard, like explosives or pithy needle, or of course a Baleful Strix main deck. Yeah, let's go with this. On the draw with a one lander. Yeah, I'm keeping it. I'm keeping this one lander. Goblin Lackey is very unlikely to hit. Though it might. And we have a relic, which is good. And let's go. I'm gonna probably just start with Relic here. I just want to clear my opponent's graveyard as much as possible from turn 1. If I play Lackey, my opponent gets to use their mana at end of turn. And let's see. Let's leave the. This is the exile zone. The graveyard will be here. And that's a Baleful Strix. Sure. Actually, I don't like this. That makes me. Since I'm so used to into that. And all right, let's play Goblin Lackey and pass. I don't want to crack this relic. Of course, the fact that we didn't hit a land drop. It's making me think that this should have been a mulligan. And this could have well be. I may be putting too much trust on this Relic of Progenitus. But I'm just calling his command now. Ooh, Liliana Hope. That's rough. That's very rough now. And I don't really beat that quite easily. Yeah, I guess I'll pass. There's no point in cycling, I think. I think I wanna. Maybe I do actually. Do I prefer cycling a. Do I prefer cycling a Gem Palm or a Relic of Progenitus? Maybe Gem Palm. Yeah, their deck relies a lot on the Snapcaster Mage F4, that's why I was so happy to draw this Relic of Progenitus, but it turns out that It's not like Reanimator where you really need to hit this. Okay, I think I'm gonna cycle now. I think I'm gonna cycle now this jump on the incinerator. Just so that I can hit a land drop. Actually, it's like the same. But I can just draw land and Opponent discards it. So maybe I should have just let it resolve and have more information. More turf fire. And I guess it's time for me to crack this relic. And the last hope will be we go up. So we have our fire to keep it down. It's a long way though. We're forced into. Yeah. This is strong. What can I do? I can top deck. If I'm putting attacks and I top deck Goblin Lackey, we can have some chances. But it will likely not attack now. Yeah. So this goes up. We draw Cavern. Okay, let's play Chieftain though. Yeah, at this point I guess. I mean, it's very likely my opponent just has a removal spell for my Chieftain. If I don't draw land, I can go Cranko and some value, but it's so unlikely my opponent with 9 cards. They don't have a, you know, removal spell or anything. Yeah. I like this deck. Good old, like 4 color Leovold without the 4th color and without Leovold, it looks like. So definitely one of the control-ish deck. Ooh, Kolaghan's Command. Yeah, the fact that they have Kolaghan's Command, it's huge against me. Alright, still think the cyber was okay. Maybe we want some of these over like tar fire. Maybe a Goblin Lack is not good on the draw. I can keep it on the play. Sorry, I can keep it. Let's go. Opening hand. That's fine. We got turn one lucky. We don't have that many things to put into play with it, but we do have a 2 land spell, actually 3 land spell with Pendulhaven. I was very close to cast Pendulhaven. Oh, Force of Will. Didn't expect Force of Will post sideboard against us. Let's stop their land in actually no. If they play any land non-fetch, I can tap in and turn so that the Warchief can attack. And tapping a fetch on an upkeep has the only merit of getting my opponent to go like Underground Sea, Brainstorm, and then I'm in a fetch land. Which is not that huge. It's better if they just go like Volcanic or Badland. I can just tap it and then attack with Warchief and get 2 damage in. Again, it's free, so I'll tap it. And I don't want to wasteland. I just play Warchief and attack. Is this Warchief result? Ooh. Yeah, just been Warchief and attack. They can't fail, I push it. And if Warchief survives, then the Ringleader costs 1 less, and yeah, makes me just curve out better. I could have also just tap to make my opponent not being able to play a Amplitude Direct next turn, since that's a beating if like hits like these two or stuff like that. Hydro Blast. Okay. Alright, no Helm to Turek. Very happy about it. Though my opponent can go Snapcaster Mage. Maybe I just Wasteland now. And play Goblin Matron. I'll kill a red. Or maybe I'll just tap in upkeep. Yeah. Tap in upkeep so my opponent can go Snapcaster Hydro Blast. And or Helm to Turek. I really want my Goblin Ringleader to resolve. And it should. Okay. We hit two goblins, which is the average, I assume. And getting for two. So we got our card advantage. We disrupted our opponent a little with our Wasteland and our Shadow on board. Five mana. I wish this chieftain was a war chief, because I could go Chieftain Matron, whereas now I can't double spell. But having Pyroblast, it's a thing. Ooh, Wasteland. I guess I will Wasteland or Badland and attack. And then play Goblin Matron post combat, so I have Pyroblast. They call against command me, I'll discard mountain. I'll discard mountain. Yeah. Then I go Goblin Matron, get Ringleader and pass. Maybe I'm just getting too much value and I should make my land drop, but I played 23 lands and it's likely that I draw those. I destroyed two badlands, so my opponent is relying on I don't know how many sources. Yeah, last up is a good one. I wish I had Pendle 11 up instead of Pyroblast. So we go Ringleader. What do we hit? Ooh, four. Nice. Seven cards in our hand against two. This is why we play Goblin Ringleader. In our Goblins deck. In as many copies as possible. So, what does my opponent know about my hand? I think I'll counter this. It's denying them. It's denying him to draw a card and etc. Alright. That last hope is dying. Ooh, it's meaning another last hope to get back a Baleful Strix. So they do a Baleful Strix. They can't trip. And what do we draw? Do we draw land? We draw Goblin Lackey. Unfortunately can't get through because of that Baleful Strix. But we can just go Chieftain Mogwar Marshal attack with all. That's kind of strong. I can also go Goblin Trashmaster now. Let's go Chieftain Mogwar Marshal. And I can have a failed push, but that's fine. Let's attack. So no failed push from our opponent. Trades there, that's fine, goes to 11. Yeah, and our card advantage is flowing here. Jace, okay. Not the best timing for Jace now. We can play around Toxic Deluge maybe. Fetch. Alright, what do they have, a landing book? Ooh, Brainstorm main phase, nice. They still have to make a land drop so they can go like, they can't go land bolt because, wow, they just concede. Yeah, I mean, When your ring leader hits four cards against a control deck, it's very very unlikely to lose. And yeah, that was it. We go 2-1. We'll be back for round number four. A lot of lands, and we get a mulligan. And we got a keep here. Ooh, Vile. I'll leave it on top. There might be a situation where I want to lead with Vials over Lucky. Plains. Yeah, Plains is a situation like that. Ooh, Mother of the Runes is a good one. I'm not sure if... Cycle? You may have it. So yeah, is a red source. Gem Pump is indeed a red source. Crankomob Boss is a legend, so against Death and Taxes, is not at its best. Alright, let's cast double Goblin Lackey. And maybe my opponent will tap their Vial, their Mother Runes, in order to prevent the Lackey from attacking. Or just kill all Lackeys, so no Lackeys allowed. Chieftain. Alright, Chieftain is a good one. If I draw a land, I can Cranko and activate it immediately because Chieftain gives other goblins haste. And my opponent already played two plows. Ooh, Masao's Cheetah is threatening. We don't draw, unfortunately, what we needed here. Very unfortunate, and no attacks. I'm gonna can play around. But I can actually play around. Yeah, but I should play around our fire here, so they shouldn't block and protect. And if they block and trade, I'm very happy. So they probably get 2 damage. And if they attack with a revoker, I only need my Mogwai Marshal to block. And if they use the Mother Runes to prevent first, that's fine. I keep Thalia. Now I want to pause a little, you know, to make them think I have Starfire, and then let it resolve. And I pass. What do we draw? Do we draw this on top land? Come on top land. No, more Chieftains. This is making my goblins very large, though. And so the thing with Thalia and Jita is that they can deal first strike and then charge Jita. So if I block with one goblin, the first strike, they kill the goblin and they are counter on Jita. Whereas if I double block, the Thalia is going to die. So, despite my goblins are very large, I think I'm passing here. Final opponent is Titan land is kind of good. I mean, we are two, definitely. We definitely are two. But... Alright, so are they keeping here? Sarah Ranger would be bad. Okay, they are keeping. And if they attack, I double block with goblins. They pass. Cool. Can we draw a land, please? Yes, we can. So, Cranko in. I'm gonna immediately tap it. To make. Are we lethal? Are we lethal? No. So, opponent has 3 blocks. You get 3, 6. 8, 12, 15, 18, but then they can gain life because the first strike. Guess we'll attack with a bunch of goblins this time. Not really, they can block and protect. Yeah, I mean, I'm not risking anything in passing here. Like, nothing really can happen. Even if my opponent kills the crank on next turn, that's still good. I'm gonna tap with Jump on Incinerator so they can't use the Murder Runes actively. Three mana. What can they play on turn on three mana? That's very annoying. Brightling. Not even a picture yet. Oh yeah, no, not even a picture. Brightling. The cool kids on the block. Maybe not as cool now against my 20,000 tokens. Okay, this is a lot of damage. 17 multiplied by 3 makes 51, and that's a lot. Sure. And I didn't need it, but it's just super overkill. Okay, so we defeated quite easily Death and Toxins in game 1. Now we're gonna have a lot of sideboard for this. So 7 cards. What do we don't like? Look at Steam Scourger once again. I think Crank on my boss, despite the meta's win this game, it's quite bad against Caracas and Plows. What else do we don't like? Maybe. I don't think this is great here. I don't know what I'm supposed to cut. I like the Tar Farm. Maybe Goblin Lackey. I'll actually cut all the Goblin Lackeys. They have a lot of creatures to block. We're on the draw. Even if I want to play, I think I don't mind cutting Goblin Lackey. Also, it's a Goblin for Ringleader, but it's a very high impact Goblin, so that's fine. One land, maybe? Gonna cut one land. And let's go. In the end, I boarded in a 2-0 mana card and a 2-1 card, so that's fine. I guess I boarded out 4 1 drops. But I don't really want to cut any of these. Maybe I cut the Chieftain? I don't know. Let's go. I ended up cutting one Chieftain for a Rishalan board. I kinda don't want to have cut any lands against a land disruption deck. Alright, playing without a vial, but we do have even for them here. I think the 2 scrapper in hand is great. Alright, so they tap my mana, that's fine. We have plenty of vials to ignore totally the Rishadan board. And they cast Brightling. Wasteland. Alright, so Rattling gives Vigilance, Lifelink, and Pumps. Do I want to cast anything? Do I want to disrupt their mana base? Maybe I maybe don't want to kill the Caracas because I don't have any legendary goblins and they might have more Caracases. So I can't just kill this and play Aether Vial. Even if they play Revoker, I have Tar Fire for that. Alternatively, I can play War Chief, so that next turn I can Goblin Matron for Ringleader and play Ringleader with my 3 lands. But my opponent, I think I really want to Wasteland them. And also, leaving untapped mana for Tar Fire is not that bad. I didn't want to kill Caracas because that was the first land they played, which means that they kind of wanted to get killed, and that's fine. So this return to its owner end. So we can live with this Brightling attacks here. Yeah, the Caracas is there. So yeah, play the well around it. Sword of War and Peace. Sure. Now, if you draw land, we can go Warchief and Artcast to Tuk Scrapper. So these all three go up. Let's see what we draw. Chieftain. Not whited, but it makes our goblins a little bit bigger. And that's enough for the Sword of War Beast to not kill any. Oh no, other goblins. So the chieftain indeed dies to it. So what can we do? What can we do here? I can Goblin Matron for not much, just Mob War Marshal. Yeah, I think I'll just pass, let them have their sword kill, their sword trigger. And then just go off a little bit more. Yeah. I'll pass. Equip, that's fine. Attack, that's fine. I'll take 7 down to 10. Opponent gets to draw a card. The next turn we will kinda go off. Okay, they do have a land with Tuk Tuk Scrapper. It's still great. So we will end of turn activate this vial to put into play Goblin Matron. The beauty? Yes. Goblin Matron that gets us a Goblin Ringleader. And then we untap. All the vials go up. And we draw another ringleader. So, I'm definitely gonna cast Tuk Tuk Scrapper on this sword. I'm gonna play Warchief, Chieftain, and Tuk Tuk Scrapper. That's what I'm gonna do. So first thing first, cast Warchief. Yes. Then cast Chieftain. And then put into play Tuk Tuk Scrapper. Yes. And then attack with all. I'm way ahead in the race here. Even if opponent plows the chieftain, that's still okay, I think. I can take some damage off Brightling. Opponent is plowing most likely the chieftain here. Yes, but that's okay. Should have plowed first so that I couldn't attack with... oh no, I guess this gives haste. Ooh, 4 mana, what is this? Cataclysm is not good, because they have 3 vials. Maybe Wrath of God, but again, I have Ringleader in hand. Gideon. Cataclysm. We also discard cards. That's fine. Oh, an artifact too? Okay, that's fine. So we decide to keep a mountain, a vial on 4, and a goblin warchief. Right? Yeah. It was good. It was definitely good. I thought that I would have kept the vials, but I don't. So now we vial in Ringleader. Yes. We hit Tarfire and Goblin Matron. Any order. We kill the Brightling. And we attack 4/4. And I can't really think of myself losing this game at this point. Goblins looks to be well equipped against those. X. So we Ringleader again, getting our classic 2 cards, and sure, let's play this, attack, opponent is super dead here. Brightling did not do as much in this game. Viola is quite late to the party. No, And we want to maintain, I think so. Our opponent's very dead here. Yeah, and we win 2-0 quite easily. Let's go to round number 5. We are round 5. We got a good one. We got a good hand. Opponent's might get to 5 to 6 right now. We have the good old decision. What do I want to lead with? I think I'll lead with Aetherite. If I'm gonna play, it's Goblin Lackey, though not having a removal spell, maybe it's again good to go with Aetherite or a Wisdom Teeth. Yeah, so it looks like we dodged all the combo decks in this league. I mean, this could be Elves, and Elves is kind of a combo deck. This could be like Maverick, maybe Enchantress, Tropical Island. Alright. Ooh, Tar Fire. Do I want to Tar Fire that or just play Aetherite? I kinda want to Tar Fire it. No, you know what? I'm just gonna play Aetherite. The thing is that we. Before disrupting our opponent mana base with like Wasteland and Tar Fire, I want to Aetherite down. And my opponent can play Infect and. Alright. No Vial. Opponent can play Infect. So that can be a combo deck. Let's see what the Ponder do. Yeah, we don't play this game, it would be huge, but I'm gonna put Mulligan to 5, so can't get too upset about this. If you're putting Mulligan to 5 every time you're on the draw, I think it's a fair trade. Okay, they do not shuffle and they pass. Ooh. Alright, I'm going to Wasteland and cast Vial. It's kinda bad to Wasteland with no Balearic in play, but I want to play around the Spell Pierce and also have Tar Fire in my hand. And wow, opponent's force of willing. Pitch a Spell Pierce. Yeah, they did have that Spell Pierce, so yeah, happy. Happy, happy. But again, we don't have any lands right now, so I can't be that happy. Ponder again. We are just looking for lands here. They have one card in hand after this Ponder. Sorry, before this Ponder. Do not shuffle. Find the Wisdom Teeth. Do they also have another play? Yeah, I'm going to just start fire this. I could have do it in upkeep, but then my opponent could have had access to like Brainstorm Fetch. Let's see, is this another Ponder? Or it's a Noble Hierarch. Glistern Elf. That's okay. I'll happily take one. I can't lose if I take one, but I don't know. I mean, maybe if my opponent's attacking means that they have some interest. Wow. Now I can lose. So let's think deeply about this. I can lose to a Berserk Invigorate. Or like become a Mass Invigorate. But if I don't lose this turn, I basically can't lose anymore. Whereas if I block and my opponent goes like another Glistern Elf, I guess it's the same. Yeah, let's block, but I regret it. I'll regret it, I'm sure. But I can also just have a pump spell, like an Invigorate, and this is still bad. Yeah. Alright. We draw land, so we are happy. Now we have plenty of blockers for the Glistering Elf. I don't want to Wasteland, because again, I can't die if I don't make a play. I make them play a Brainstorm, and obviously that wouldn't have happened if I Wastelanded, but it could have died. Actually, could I? No. I couldn't have died because they wouldn't have a drop, like a forest. But still. I think a Mogwai Marshall now, it's huge. Alright. I don't want to pay Eco. Nah. Champ on Incinerator. That's good. I'd rather cycle in this than Wasteland at this point. Kinda want to find lands and yeah. Forest. Okay. Do they have Blighted Agent? They do. They do have Blighted Agent. You can just cast Chieftain and kill them in two turns. And I accept dying to a top deck. This is 6 down to 9. And then the Mogwai Marshal is 4 more power next turn. So I can accept dying to a top deck. Please don't have it though. That would be pretty sad if you do. Okay, no. Oof. And that's 10 damage. Alright, good game. We had a lot of close decisions in this game. And it panned out pretty well. Oof, okay. So against Infect, we're gonna have Pyrokinesis, Sharpshooter, Chain Whirler. Played against a lot of creature decks, so those were definitely good in those matchups. That was it, I think. I can't have Pithy Needle for Inkmoth Nexus, but I'd rather. I mean, I already have Port and Wasteland, so I think those were enough. Stink Scourger once again going out. Cranko can go out. Trashmaster is good. Maybe Warring Leader. And one Chieftain. Let's go. Pulling Mulligan to. Kept on 7 this time, and we have to Mulligan. Alright, do we find lands? We do. We're underway with a turn 1 Terrifier, turn 2 Mogwai Marshal. I'm going to kill Noble Hierarch. Maybe don't kill the Glistern Elf since we have Mogwai Marshal. Uncounterable. Yeah, I'm trying to kill that. If they have Daze, that's fine. I mean, I'd rather them not have it, but if they do, there's nothing much I can do about it. My curve here is pretty much planned. I'm gonna go, ooh, Invigorate. Nice, okay. We're trading Invigorate for Terrifier. We're gonna curve Mogwai Marshal into Jample, so I can't do that. Oh, double block here. If my opponent offers. Ooh, they don't have another land. So I'm definitely going to cycle onto the Noble Hierarch. They might save it again with another pump spell, but that's fine. Jump on creating card advantage all the time. It's pretty great. Goblin Trashmaster, destroy an artifact, it's not irrelevant. They do have Inkmoth Nexus. So with Trashmaster in play, they can't kill us through that. A Ringleader again, maybe we should cut more of that and keep Chieftain just for a curve consideration. They go Brainstorm end of turn without a land in hand, so they can get Brainstorm locked. Playing Brainstorm end of turn is not usually a great play, but a combo deck need to do it more often than like Crisis Control or Miracles. I mean, I guess Miracles is a different deck. Uses Brainstorm in a different dimension, just like Shadowless Agent too. Okay, they did find a land. That's fine. They probably don't want to do anything. We don't pay that. Don't pay Eco. Draw Goblin Lackey. I'm gonna just cycle this onto the Noble Hierarch. They don't have a Blighted Agent, so I'm happy to just I mean, they're probably gonna use a pump spell, I think. If they don't, I'm very happy with this trade. I'm doing it main phase because if I draw land, I can cast Goblin Lackey. And also just to make a land drop. I have four mana cards in my hand. I have to make land drops. Okay, they're thinking a lot about it, so they must have something. They must have like a pump spell. They can't have a counter magic. This is just cycle ability. So you can only stifle it. Raise them in response. So they know the top card and they decided to brainstorm. Let's see. They use the land. Maybe they have like Blossoming Defense for Vines or Vast Food. Vines, okay. Draw a card. Mogwai Marshal. That's fine, Mogwai Marshal is not bad. Opponent has another Noble Hierarch. Oh, yeah, that was a kind of bad since I can't double block here, I have to just jump. Alright. Gonna cast Goblin Lackey first so they can date it. And then I cast Mogwai Marshal Uncounterable. I'll just chomp with Mogwai Marshal here and attack with a goblin. I have two blocks. Actually, I have three. Not that I want to block with Lucky, but there can be a situation where I do it. So many small creatures into play. Kind of a good game here. Alright. I'm very happy if they attack, because I'm not gonna pay the eco cost, so might as well just throw it under the bus. Now the Chieftain is going to make Goblin Lackey as a 2-2. That's better. Mogwai Marshal so good against those decks. I mean, it's just a good card. It's bad against combo, of course. But... Inkblood Nexus. Drew Tarfire. Interesting. Huh. Yeah. I'll play Chieftain. And attack with Goblin Lackey for sure. Maybe even Chieftain. If they use a pump spell to kill it, I'm happy. I think I'll go like this. Maybe even this. I think only one goblin back. And my opponent can just submerge it, though. Yeah, though, what can they do? I think I'll leave only one goblin back. It's okay. They submerge my Goblin Chain Whirler or just dismember it. I think they have to block Goblin Lackey for sure. Yeah. Okay. Hydro Blast. Alright, that's a trade. That may have been Hydro Blast meant that if I just pass with Tarfire up, it's pretty bad mana efficiency. Alright, die to become immense. And of course, like two pump spell. Looks like they don't have them, so they just pass. And we drew a 4 drop. That's clunky. I kind of have to pass here because I need to Tarfire the Inkmoth Nexus. Oh, actually, I can Tarfire Inkmoth Nexus. In combat, so I should have attacked for 2. I don't think it matters a lot though. Ooh, they just moved to combat here. They don't want to expose their Inkmoth Nexus to my removal spell. They can't play a pump spell because I could just kill the Glycerin Elf in response. Second input Nexus. They want to kill a Noble Hierarch, I guess I do. Land. Now let's play Ringleader. I don't want to play Trashmaster. Yes, it stops them from comboing it, but it just doesn't progress my game. Not good hit here. I could have not triple block, but last turn, but if I don't draw land, then, like, if I knew I would have drawn a land, I would have just chump blocked the Glycerin Elf instead of tripling, because then Trashmaster would be a nice check to the Nexus and also pumping my team. But again, not knowing what was up, this is okay. Again, I die to double pump spell, I don't die to invigorate, put in with a weird sequencing. Now, if they draw Invigorate, they don't kill me. Whereas they could have if they activated both Nexus. What about Matar Fire? Looks like they're pumping their Nexus. Invigorate. And Invigorate. Now what's this? Vines? Okay, sure. I die. That's okay. I could have left Trashmaster up. Ooh, become immense. That's a lot. Could have left Trashmaster up. But then again, I kinda... Maybe I should have done it. Maybe it was bad. Okay, so... I think I like to cut another Ringleader for a Warchief. And that's about it. Oh, Stink Scourger is good with Vile. Cut another Ringleader. Let's go with this. On the play. And with a good end. Goblin Lackey with Pyrokinesis. I can't accept the 2-for-1 of the Pyrokinesis since the Goblin Lackey will connect. Also, my opponent, if they play like Noble Hierarch, I can't just attack. They block, they pump, and I play Pyrokinesis. That's also good. Let's see. Hydro Blast. That's unfortunate. Now I need to top the clans. That was very unfortunate, the fact that they had Hydro Blast. They play like not many, probably. I kind of regret the second game had I played. Had I played Trashmaster. Could have been better, though. They could have had Hydro Blast. And I would have much rather have Ringleader. Yeah, the fact that they drew the Become Immense afterwards was definitely good. Land, yes. Not only it's a land, it's like the best land. So making me Curbonite way better now. But not having an infect creature really makes me think that. I don't know what's their hand actually. They might have a Crimson Zenith and they wait for 4 mana to cast it for 3 to get Viridian Corruptor. Let's see. Blighted Agent. Alright. We don't pay eco. This goes up. What do we draw? Jam Palm or Goblin Lackey? Okay, I guess I'll play Goblin Lackey. I can play Pyrokinesis around days. I'm quite sure they don't have Spell Pierce anymore in their deck. So I'm not afraid of leaving 2 mana up to pay for Spell Pierce. I don't want to use Pyrokinesis right now. Of course. I could have maybe used it in my turn. Pitched Goblin Warchief. Since next turn I can go Goblin Matron. It's okay, if they have a lot of a pump spell I lose. And I could just avoided it. No, I guess Pyrokinesis is just straight. Yeah, I think I'm losing here. I am losing here. Yeah, I have to do this. I should have done it in my turn. If I do it in my turn, my opponent has to use an Invigorate. Whereas now they can just play another Invigorate. Or I can become immense. And I'm dead. Felt like this match is good for Goblins. We somehow lost. Okay. And that is it. Good games. 3-2. Still a good record. We lost to combo, but I think we could have done better that game too. Just having Trashmaster in play was great. We could have played around something. My opponent ended up having, which is like 2 pump spell and no like interaction with it. Alright, We still had fun. The deck was very hard to play. I'm sure I made plenty of mistakes, and I mentioned them. So clearly, you got to learn and interact with me. So there's that. And I'm thankful for you to watch. Remember you to press like on YouTube channel and subscribe to the channel to get all the legacy video and more from ChannelFireball.com. It's everything. So see you next time. Goodbye.